She's been in lots of stuff. Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. and Gallivant, as is he. You've seen him in It's Christmas Eve and The Mistletoe Secret and a whole lot more. Now, from the new movie On the 12th Date of Christmas, please welcome Mallory Jansen and Tyler Hynes. Hey, guys.
Hi, guys.
Hi, it's so good to see you.
Good to see you. This movie is absolutely sweet. We love the fact that it's based on the 12 days of Christmas. And we want to know all about your characters in this great movie and how the 12 days of Christmas actually plays into the story. So, Mallory, you go ahead and start us off.
Of course. Well, this is just such a fun romantic comedy, guys. It's about two pretty incompatible game designers who team up to create a citywide scavenger hunt around Chicago. So I play Jennifer Holloway. She's originally from Iowa, and she's moved to Chicago in the hopes of progressing her career and getting promoted to head game creator at Big City Quest. And she gets her big opportunity when she's paired up with Aiden on the Devonshire Hotels account, which is a huge opportunity for her. But working with Aiden proves to be a little challenging in the beginning. So it's really about these two finding a way of working together and getting the job done before Christmas Eve.
That was a great summary, too, by
beautiful.
The way.
That was beautiful.
It really was.
Tyler, you want to add in there? Did she forget anything?
I'm going to be terrible now. After that, she's going to hit every single point. There's no way I can have looked at that. Yeah. So wait, what didn't we do? Oh, we didn't talk about the dates. I mean, we do some pretty beautiful dates in this movie. We some of them are actually a part of the scavenger hunt. Some of them are just ourselves being cute and adorable. We go to a Christmas tree farm. We go skating. We go... we do some painting, we get some hot cocoa and listen to some carolers.
Well, we actually have a really fun clip of one of those little scenes you just mentioned. It's where Jennifer and Aiden are taking an art class for research for one of their romantic scavenger hunt date locations. Take a look.
Hey, great work on your tree.
Mine?
Yeah, well, both of you.
I think she meant yours.
She did mean mine,
She did.
Who would have known? I wasn't even paying attention.
Well, that's the secret from now on.
Okay.
Hey, we should take a selfie. If we have pictures of all the locations, we can put it in the presentation for Wanda to help her visualize what our participants will do. Okay, we should probably get close, make it look like an actual date.
Sure, yeah, of course. We should probably get the art in here, huh?
Oh, yeah. No, yours.
Mine.
Yours, yeah.
My Picasso, hey, thank you. Oh, wait, the Partridge Center.
Parasider.
What did I say?
I don't know.
Okay.
Smile.
Lush?
Yeah. Starving.
Oh, that is so sweet.
You guys are so good. You really are.
I know. Oh, my goodness.
Some tension, some love tension, yes.
Yeah. Something tells me you two are going to fall in love. Now, I know you all got to film in really cool locations along the way, but Tyler, you say that you both had the most fun on your final day of filming because, well, it was a little bit tricky.
Yeah, we were skating. The last day was a big skating day, and Mallory's character does some pretty impressive skate moves. And there was a lot going on, and luckily I was able to be her stunt double, and it all worked out.
Tyler, you can admit that I was the best skater you've ever seen.
I can't do a triple axel. You didn't see it.
Guys, this is, I just said I'm Australian, and we don't really have much experience when it comes to snow and ice. Well, I certainly didn't. Ice skating was definitely something I hadn't done before, and I had to be paired up with a coach as soon as I arrived. And it turns out it's really hard to skate. I thought it was easy.
Mallory, I actually learned how to skate as a Canadian. This is an embarrassing thing to say. I actually learned how to skate on a Hallmark film as well, so good for you.
Wow.
On the Christmas Ornament is where I learned how to skate. I never skated as a kid, and so well done. But it's interesting too, because you bring up a pretty interesting point. As actors, we almost always immediately say yes when we're up for a role, and we're like, yeah, we can do that, absolutely, yeah, sign me up, no problem. And then we get the role, we're like, oh boy, we got to work on this a little bit.
Oh my God.
You know, we got to learn a new skill often. So Tyler, is that something that you can relate to, that you've experienced in your career as well?
Yes. One of the first movies I did with Hallmark was with Leanne Rimes. It was called Christmas. It's Christmas Eve.
Yeah.
And my character was a music teacher, and he played the piano. And as you all know, Leanne is obviously very musically talented. So I had hopes of trying to learn the pieces that were playing in the movie. But I quickly discovered that that was not going to happen. I was not that talented of a person. And yeah. So I just... The whole thing.
You just faked it. Well, you probably picked up a little bit too. By the way, It's Christmas Eve is going to be airing all through Countdown to Christmas, everybody.
I love it too. It was one of my favorites.
Yeah, it's a really good one. And Mallory, other than a little bit ice skating, how about you? Can you relate to that?
I certainly can. I feel like every project we have to learn something new, which is great. You know, every day is different from the last. But when I shot Gallivant a couple of years ago, I definitely had to learn a lot of new skills, and, you know, singing was the number one skill. I had a little bit of experience, but not a whole lot. And dancing and sword fighting.
Whoa.
And horse riding.
Yes.
So definitely a lot of new skills that I learned out of that experience. So that was, it was really fun.
That is a lot of fun. All right. Well, something we do know that you can do is have scavenger hunts, because we wanted to have a little bit of fun with you all. So we sent you on a little scavenger hunt in your own homes, like your characters create in the movie. And we gave you a list of items that you needed to find around the house. Now, neither one of you have seen either of these, any of these items that you're about to show us. So the first one we asked you to find, you guys ready? You ready?
Yes, let's do it.
The first one we asked you to find in your home, which I thought was really funny, was an expired food item from your kitchens. So Mallory, we'll start with you. What do you have to show us?
Okay, I have all-purpose flour that was overdue a very long time ago because I tried to make cookies and it was a terrible failure. I'm not a baker. I'm not like my character, Jennifer Holloway, that's for sure.
There you go. What about you, Tyler?
What I ended up finding was hummus. This was all I was able to get.
There you go.
I was expired. And you know what? It's only like, I think, a week overdue. So
that is not bad. In my book, I would still eat it.
That's a week overdue is fine. Fine. It's a suggestion, really.
That's right. That's how I look at it. Okay, now we also both asked you to submit a future star of tomorrow childhood photo. So we got to see these. Let's check them out.
Oh,
there they are.
Yes.
Future star
really
of tomorrow.
Sweet. Tyler, are you sleeping?
You know, Tyler, one of those photos really looks more like a future star of tomorrow than the other. I mean, you know.
Don't come at my Dumb and Dumber haircut, okay, Cameron? It was a really popular haircut at the time. I took it upon myself to give it to myself, and I'm very proud of that haircut.
Yeah.
Both of those photos are really adorable. And then finally, we asked you both to show us something that means Christmas to you. Mallory, let's start with you.
Okay, so this requires a little bit of explanation. I'm going to put this on.
Aww.
It is a paper crown, and I don't know if it's a thing here in the US, but in Australia, we have a tradition where we have these things called Christmas crackers at place settings. And, you know, to break the ice when we sit down, we break the cracker with whoever we're sitting next to, and this little paper crown falls out, as well as like a lame joke and a cheap toy or something.
We do that in Canada too. I don't know if Tyler does, but I did as a kid.
I still do.
What about you, Tyler?
You guys have a clip, I believe. And the man that it involves.
Oh my goodness.
Somewhere in the house. There he is.
Is that real?
The man, the legend. That is a real thing. That is my little man named Rusty James, AKA Rusty Santa Claus James. And that is his Christmas costume. And he is going to be bringing the Christmas cheer this year in our home.
That was hysterical.
Like a stuffed animal.
I want to get my dog in one of those.
Oh, Red would not look the same as Rusty James.
You guys are amazing. Thanks for playing along. We love this film. Thanks for taking the time to be with us today. Be sure to catch Mallory and Tyler on the 12th date of Christmas this Sunday at 8, 7 Central right here on Hallmark Channel.